Hey everybody, Jeremy Good here. Greetings from Zanesville, Ohio. Local time here is 3:09. The temperature is at 61 degrees. Beautiful, beautiful 61 degrees. We still got 384 miles to go. Oh, it made me sad. I did a fuel video today over there and I can't even remember that the pilot, for some reason, it failed to upload. So it's all been deleted. Yeah, it would have been a good video too. Life goes on. So we're all filled up with fuel, DEF, and reefer fuel. Got our coffee. A refill from Fillmore. I tried. They have a new coffee from. Oh, what do you call that? New taste, the new flavor. Pilot has a new flavor. It says French vanilla. It smells real good. Yeah, I don't know. It tastes a lot. It smells a lot better than it tastes. I don't know. I guess don't care for it too much. So this will be my last one. My first and the last. But as long as it's got caffeine in it, that's all that matters. As long as it's stronger than battery acid, we'll be in business. It's a nice looking clean truck. Speaking of clean truck, hey baby blue, when are we gonna take a shower, baby blue? You need a bath. Well, I had me some Illinois rain shower last night, Johnny Be Good. That's all I need. Oh, baby blue. Well, we'll catch you guys a little bit later. Peace. Hey, everybody. Johnny Begin here. Greetings from Ohio. Alright, we're gonna take this 470 east this time. Remember that Holy Smokies video that I did last week? I was on the middle lane and that four-wheeler Yes, he was from Wisconsin. I was in that middle lane and he jumped right over here. Right there, that's where he crossed that line. They shocked the crap out of me. Alright, we have 320 miles to Bogglesville, Pennsylvania. Roughly 5 hours and 41 minutes of driving we need to do. Temperature here is 61 degrees. Once again, today is February 3rd, 2016. See you over there in the West Virginia line, or a little bit down the road. Peace. Hey everybody, okay, we're coming up to Bel Air, Bridgeport, Pennsylvania. Anyway, we're coming up to the Pennsylvania state line, I believe. I've always liked this bridge over here. Bel Air, Bridgeport, Wheeling, Moundsville. We want to go to Washington, PA. Ohio River, there you go. Ah, I was mistaken. West Virginia welcomes you. Like a really old town, doesn't it? So it's Ohio, West Virginia, then Pennsylvania. climb, baby, blue climb. I'm a climbing, I'm a climbing. Jake brake right now is on high. It's almost hard to notice it. Motorcycles are out today. I don't blame them. It's 64 degrees. Meanwhile, in Sheboygan, it was snowing 3 inches this morning. See you in a little bit. Peace. Hey everybody, John Good here once again. Okay, we are approaching the Pennsylvania state line, I believe. Less than a mile, I think. There's a big old welcome sign here. We still had 301 miles to go. Mile marker 14. Here we go. Washington County. There you go. Pennsylvania welcomes you. State of independence. Last week I was reminded to why that is. One of you said it was the Declaration of Independence. Thank you for that knowledge. Catch you guys later. Peace. Hey everybody. I believe this is somewhere or even Washington, Pennsylvania, I think. Yeah, it's gotta be. Yep, Washington, PA. Alright, we're only 2.3 miles to our turnoff here, which is on, well, we don't really turn, but that's where 70 and 79 meet up. By the way, just thought of something. I'm not the original concept of this, but the presence of you guys heard of the presence of China in the Spratly Islands, you know, that chain of islands that's being claimed by the Philippines, also being claimed by Japan. I think it's also being claimed by Indonesia or Malaysia, something like that. There's quite a dispute going on with that island for many years. And I'm sure you guys have seen this on the news, where China has literally built an island. They found a very shallow area and they just dump, I mean, millions and millions of tons of gravel, sand, and filling material. It's a man-made island, and China is building a base, a military base. And of course, the US and the Philippines and everybody else are all upset about it. I was just thinking, because of this, I don't think they're going to be able to drive China out of that island. But because of this, I think the Americans were going to return. I'm pretty sure they're going to return to the Philippines and build a U.S. base in the Philippines again, like they did before. If you guys remember, Subic Bay and Clark Air Base, Clark was the Air Force. Subic Bay was the naval base in the Philippines. And they were forced out by Mount Pinatubo when the volcano erupted. But I really seriously think that the Americans are going to return over there and establish a U.S. base again. I'm having a little bit of a mixed emotion on that because, I don't know, it'll be good for the economy, good for business, but then the corruption comes, the prostitution, the drug dealings, the child molestations, and yeah, it was ugly. Some parts of it were ugly, real ugly. When the U.S. base was present in the Philippines, and I would suppose every boom town that happens, all of that goes with it. So, I don't know. I think I'd rather not have the U.S. base returned, but for security reason. But then again, I don't know. Whatever it will be, right? South Morgantown. So, how far are we to the Pennsylvania Turnpike from here? 36 miles. All right, we'll see you over there later. Peace. Hey everybody, Johnny B. Good here. Welcome to Twilight, Pennsylvania. I bet you've never heard of Twilight, Pennsylvania before, huh? Welcome to the Twilight Zone. City by the river. Pretty, isn't it? Look at that.